Hey, it's Bee here. Today's a great day to learn. Whoa! Mia, you've got some really cool moves. How can we learn how to dance like you? Oh, you're right, Mia. We first need to learn the four fundamental movements. Translation, reflection, rotation, and dilation. These four fundamental movements are known as transformations, and today we're going to look at different shapes to learn all about them. One of the four types of transformations is called a translation, which is when a figure slides or shifts from one place to another. Take a look at figure G on this coordinate plane. We can translate or slide it up. We can translate it down. We can translate or shift it to the left. Or we can translate it to the right. Let's just say we just showed this to a stranger who didn't see the translation happen. How would they know which heart was the original? They wouldn't. That's why when we're working with transformations, it's important to distinguish between the pre-image and the image. The pre-image is the original figure before the transformation. The image is the final figure after the transformation. Figures won't always be labeled pre-image and image, though. Another way to distinguish between them is putting an apostrophe next to the letter of the image, like this. The pre-image is just called figure G, and the image is read with the apostrophe as figure G prime. Having different labels for them makes it easier to tell which one's the original pre-image. Reflection is another type of transformation. When you look at your reflection in a mirror, the image is a flipped version of your actual face. Reflection is when a figure is flipped over a line. See figure K here? Imagine that the y-axis line is the mirror. If we reflect the pre-image, figure K, over the y-axis, its flipped version will appear on the other side of the y-axis. This image is labeled K prime. And just like your face and its reflection in a mirror, the pre-image and image will always be the same distance from the line used for the reflection. Pretty cool, huh? But let's say we wanted to reflect figure K over the x-axis instead. In your guided notes, go ahead and sketch what you think figure K prime would look like. The x-axis is now the mirror. It's the line that the pre-image will be flipped over. Reflecting figure K over the x-axis would create a figure K prime that looks like this. The next transformation is rotation. What are some things that rotate? Whether it's the wheel of a car or an electric fan, rotation is when a figure moves in a circular motion around a point. In this course, the origin will be that point of rotation. That's 0, 0 at the center of the coordinate plane. Let's use figure R to demonstrate rotation around the origin. When rotating, the distances of each point will always be the same distance from the origin. The origin is like the center of the fan. The figure rotates around the origin, just like the blades of a fan rotate around the center of the fan. For example, This point on the tip of the arrow of figure R will always be the same distance from the origin, and as it rotates around the origin, it naturally creates a circular motion. We can either rotate it clockwise or counterclockwise around the origin. Rotating the pre-image figure R clockwise means moving it in the circular direction of the clock, like so, creating these R prime images. We can also rotate the pre-image figure R counterclockwise, which is in the opposite direction of the clock, like so, creating these R prime images. The last transformation is called dilation, which is a fancy name for creating scaled images. It's when the size of a figure is changed without changing the shape. Let's dilate this figure W. Applying a scale factor of 1/2, the dimensions of figure W prime will be exactly half the dimensions of the pre-image, but still the same shape. Let's apply a dilation that will enlarge figure W instead. In your guided notes, sketch figure W prime after a dilation by a scale factor of 2. Dilating figure W by a scale factor of 2 would create a figure W prime with dimensions that are exactly double the dimensions of the pre-image. Wow, learning the four transformations was pretty fun. I must admit though, one of them feels a bit different than the other three transformations. Let's look at them side by side. Which transformation creates an image that is not congruent to the pre-image? An image created by dilation is not congruent to the pre-image. It's the same shape, but not the same size. Whereas in the other three transformations, the images are the same shape and size as their pre-images, meaning they are congruent. That makes sense since we're just sliding, flipping, or turning the pre-image from one place to another. The orientation of the image may change, but the image is still congruent to the pre-image. For the remainder of this unit, we're going to focus on just these three transformations. Because these transformations do not change the size or shape of the pre-image, we call them rigid transformations, which are transformations that create congruent images. Translation, reflection, and rotation are rigid transformations. Okay, let's look at three examples to apply what you've learned so far. For each pause moment, answer questions directly in the guided notes. Take a look at figure Z and figure Z prime. What transformation is this called? And which axis was the pre-image flipped over? Pause now to answer these questions in your guided notes. This transformation is a reflection. And if we weren't sure, the second question asked which axis the pre-image was flipped over. That key word confirms that this is indeed a reflection. The pre-image, figure Z, was reflected over the y-axis to create the image, figure Z prime. Okay, next example. The pre-image figure B was dilated to create the image figure B prime. Are these two figures congruent? Why or why not? Pause now. These figures are not congruent because dilation changes the size of the pre-image. That's also why dilation is not a rigid transformation. Okay. Final example. Which transformation occurred here? And here's a tricky one for you. Did this image turn clockwise or counterclockwise around the origin? Pause now. Pre-image Q was rotated. Whether it was a clockwise or counterclockwise rotation really depends on how you look at it. Pre-image Q could have rotated clockwise, like this, to create image Q prime. Or it could have rotated counterclockwise, like this, to create image Q prime. Both directions of rotation can create the same image. Well, Mia and I think you're ready to put these moves to the test. Continue reviewing what you've learned about transformations by completing this lesson's checklist. After you finish with the guided notes, complete today's practice levels. And remember, math is everywhere. Keep exploring. See you next time. Hey.